हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑल टू अ ब्रांड न्यू वीडियो ऑफ GTA ग्लोबल टेक्निक्स ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. इन टू टूडेज वीडियो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिकोड और व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड इज व्हाट आर विंडोज, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ विंडोज एंड व्हाट आर द अंडरस्टैंडिंग्स दैट यू एंड मी एज डिजाइनर्स हैव पर्टेनिंग टू विंडोज. सो विंडोज कैन बी क्लासिफाइड अंडर वेरियस हेडर्स. So they can be classified under materials used. So if at all I classify them as materials used, I'll start basically from wood. Then there was a time wherein we used to have only MS frames and the glass was just stuck to it. Then came up something called aluminium, which is now also very famous. Then came up PVC, UPVC, we know it. Then came up composites. Composites means aluminium plus wood, aluminium plus UPVC, GI plus UPVC for the reinforcement. So as time passed, as time lapsed, the size of the window kept on increasing. Initially, if you remember, we had only a jharokha, a small opening. Now this opening has turned up to a French window, which is almost height of a wall. Hardly we leave almost 200 or 300 at the top, and at the bottom we leave almost like 20 or 30 or say 100 mm. So the entire stability of this as a system relies 100% now on designers like you and me to justify their performances based on the wind load, based on the seismic loading, based on the acoustic. So these windows can be secondly classified as the way they are being operated. So I start with fixed window. The name itself suggests fixed means it has no function, it has just a functionality of being a viewpoint. So anywhere you see a window which has no opening, that is a fixed window, mostly used for hotel buildings. Then comes openable, we also call it sash, we also call it casement windows. So these casement windows can open up from any direction, can be sideways, can be top, can be from the bottom, just to allow the fresh air to come in. Then came up sliding window. Now this sliding window had various parameters associated to it. So that's the second part of the window series, wherein we would be talking about what are the components that go inside a sliding window. Apart from glass and aluminium, there are many components that go into the manufacturing and the assembly of sliding window. So then came up sliding window. After sliding, there came up a requirement from a designer to have a sliding and folding. Now, depending upon the hardware used and their operation, we classified windows further as fixed, casement, sliding, folding, sliding and folding. We also have tilt and turn. Now we also have, with the help of beautiful hardwares, we also have a window which is lift and slide. Now this window being lift and slide has the best possible water tightness and air permeability onto the performance values. And it can be locked at any point of time. At any junction you want to lock it, you can lock it with the help of just those levers. So depending upon this, we classified windows onto their operational and hardware used. Now also, since the window was the only opening outside your facade which connected you to the atmosphere, it also depended upon the way the opening size was available. So sometimes we used to have an open area, into a curvature form or a trapezoidal form. So that type of window used to be called as a bay window. Sometimes there used to be a window just above the door for the ventilation purpose. So that window used to be called as ventilation window. So windows in and around, even if I don't tell you, you can, as a designer, you can also figure out at least 10 to 15 different types of windows upon their operations, upon their materials used, upon their way it is being operated, the way it is serving the purpose. So there are also hotels which operate into picture windows. Now, what is a picture window? You have a rectangular box. You have two panels which are openables. They can be either sliding inside or opening outside. And you have one bigger glass which is fixed. It is also called into facade language. It is also called as X, 2X and X. So we are, when I call about the X length of span of the window, this X and this X are similar, whereas the picture window, whereas the view is not obstructed and you have 2X view from that center fixed portion of the window. So not only pertaining to windows, we also have windows which have composites into them. So what are composites? We have fixed window combined with a sliding window. So at least for the Mumbai region, there is a phenomena called fungible FSI, wherein there is a fixed window at the bottom and the sliding slides over the fixed window. At times it also becomes reverse, so the sliding is at the bottom and you have fixed portion at the top. So there are various combinations of these. There are sometimes you have two track, depending upon number of tracks also we classify windows as far as sliding goes. So we classify them as two track, two shutter windows, three track, three shutter windows, four track, four shutter windows, and now just the multiplication factor. So two track, four shutter windows, three track, six shutter windows, four track, eight shutter windows. But in case of eight shutter windows or six shutter windows, what generally people opt for is the last two, the corner two panels are being fixed so that there is no 100% opening. That brings us to the next level of classification on percentage opening. So sometimes you get 30% opening, sometimes you get 33.333, sometimes you get 50% opening, sometimes you get 70% opening, and at times in case of a sliding folding, you get 100% opening. You also have a pivotal window which has a central pivot, either vertical or horizontal. So depending upon the various ifs and buts and say the observation skills of a designer, you can classify these windows into various segments. Now, answering the most important question here, that what is a system window and how it is different from a market section, or say into market we have n number of possibilities of windows system available for us. How will a buyer decide which to buy, or how will an architect specify which to buy? So if we go to a market to buy a section, and if we are staying in a very low level area wherein it is 0 to 10 floors building, and we don't see winds coming in, we don't have too much of traffic and traction coming over there. So now here we can go with market sections, no worries onto it. But once you ask for performance, that is the reason, that is the arena wherein you require system windows. Because system windows are equipped with all the structural calculations. They are equipped with almost all the accessories and locks and handles which are specifically tailor-made for the system. So it's like into a medical terminology, if at all you want to go to a general physician who gives you same tablets for headache, for stomach ache, for body ache. Or you would like to go to a specialist who knows, okay, you have a stomach ache, you need to have this tablet. If you have a headache, you need to have this tablet. So system companies are like doctors for a layman. Higher you stay, the better system performance you expect. And apart from this expectancy, we come on to the last classification of windows depending upon the glass used. So we call it single glass window. If at all we are using a laminated glass, we call it a laminated glass window. If at all we use a series of lamination plus DGU, insulated glass units, so we call it a performance window. If at all we are expecting it to be a bullet resistant window, so the series would be with laminated plus air gaps plus laminated glass. So that is again a different classification. At times into lab chemical laboratories, this glass is also being replaced by polycarbonate sheets. So again we come back to the classification. That's how the entire window fraternity, for a layman it is just like khidki lagani hai. But which type? Sometimes even my customers or say my clients get rattled if I ask them these many questions. But if at all you want to have a consistent, long-lasting, performing window without leakage, without complaints, without whistling noise, without failures, you need to have system windows. Answering to all my queries, the life expectancy, as well as the design capabilities of a window. So that sums up the entire typology or say the classification of windows. Into next, we would be jumping on to the components of a sliding window. So if you feel that you know the components of the sliding window, please comment it in the comment section and let me know how many you think you know it. However, I would be answering them in the next video. And if at all you come across any window which has been missed by me, please mention it. I would like to thank you for the additional typology in the next video and would shout out your name for this video. And it's been a strong recommendation from friends and subscribers that please do ask the viewers to subscribe. So it's a genuine request for keeping me going compiling these many videos. Please hit the subscribe button and do share it with your friends if you like the same. Once again, thanks for watching.